China's repeatedly stated that it's going to be the global leader in artificial intelligence by 2030. What's the stance of the U.S. on this? Do you know what you have from the president? Okay, we must develop, control, and use artificial intelligence to secure the country's future. AI development is a strategic issue to whether we can grasp future opportunities. Only issue, this is President Xi Jinping, president of China. This video will analyze the competition or race between the US and China. What are the strengths and weaknesses of each other? And then is China going to be able to overtake the US as the global leader in artificial intelligence by 2030? Those quotes were from Xi Jinping, but the US currently holds a position of strength. So let's talk about where the US and China are today with AI, where they will be in a decade. And at the end, I'll toss in a little bonus, the Thucydides Trap. China got a big wake-up call in 2016 when DeepMind's AlphaGo defeated Grandmaster Lee Sedol at the game of Go. This rocked the AI world and heavily shaped the Chinese Communist Party's plans for the future. Meanwhile, here in the United States, nobody outside of the Go and AI communities even knew that Lee Sedol was dethroned. In 2017, China started laying out an aggressive strategy and investment plan to become the leader in artificial intelligence by 2030. Well, where are we today? That's a great question, Michelle. China and the United States are both rising AI powers, with each approaching AI and innovation differently. China is approaching the pursuit of AI as you would think of a centrally controlled government, setting up innovation zones, directing local governments, heavily directing investing, collecting and leveraging troves of personal data, and publishing national strategies. The United States is pursuing AI, also how you might expect. It's taking a more democratic and free market approach. The large companies and academic institutions are taking the lead and are continuing to do what they've done without much change. The United States has large companies whose investments in AI have allowed them to dominate those areas. Google, now Alphabet, Facebook, Amazon have become trillion-dollar companies thanks to AI. And other up-and-comers like Tesla are quickly crushing the competition. U.S. academia also continues to conduct groundbreaking research in areas from deep learning to general adversarial networks. If you haven't seen my video on the basics of AI yet, I would encourage you to do so. These videos are very short, to the point, and written for the layman. Link above. Chinese equivalents like Alibaba, Tencent, and Baidu are making great strides with AI, but haven't gotten close to the same level as their American counterparts yet. One of the stark differences between China and the US is the willingness of the users, companies, and governments concerning data boundaries. China has 4 times the number of people in the US, and much more data is collected on the average person in China versus the US. For instance, mobile payments in China make up around 50 times more than the US. That's a lot of data. Reports vary, but the average Chinese person is about 30% more likely to hand over their personal information and is more comfortable with mass collection for the common good than the average US person.
And people are more open, are more willing to, you know, use the new technologies to solve their problems.
A stark example of these Chinese forays into personal security is widespread use of computer vision to identify, track, and report on incursions. Chinese cameras literally will watch you jaywalking, be able to tell using facial recognition who you are, display your offense and name on a large TV while deducting a fine from your bank account. That is crazy. Could you imagine if this happened in the US? How much do people detest the less intrusive red light cameras, for instance? But think about all the data China is able to collect and utilize to get a deeper understanding of people. Data is a strategic resource. It is the electricity that powers AI. You can have the most advanced algorithms in the world, but if you don't have enough of the right data, they're pretty useless. Somewhat because of Chinese focus on controlling their populace, crime, public safety, they've come to lead in areas such as computer vision, speech recognition, and drones.
These glasses that can recognize faces linked to the government's national database to help boost arrests.
How advanced is this technology?
This is cutting edge.
Wu Fei is CEO of a company that makes the glasses. He claims he doesn't know how the government intends to use his technology.
I have no idea.
Really?
Yes.
Do you trust the government the way they're using your technology?
Sorry, I can't answer this.
The US is leading in a lot of areas, such as autonomous vehicles, robotics, business, and ethics. It'll be interesting to see how these areas of dominance change in that next decade. The US leads in AI research, assessed by the number of papers, patents, awards, novel breakthroughs, while China is beginning to lead in AI application. China has for a long time relied heavily on Western groundbreaking developments and research. They quickly adopt and tailor them to their needs. Some would say they flat out copy them, or IP theft. The environment of AI facilitates this transfer somewhat due to its openness and frequently low barrier to implementation. Once there's a groundbreaking discovery or innovation in AI, there's usually a paper published shortly thereafter, a GitHub repository posted, or a toolbox that is shared. These characteristics have enabled China to stay close behind the United States. They're close, but can they transition from drafting right behind the US to overtaking us and running away with the lead? That's a great question, Carl. You must be watching a lot of NASCAR. That's the trillion-dollar question, actually, and the most difficult to answer. Most signs are pointing to show that they will be able to overtake the US in many areas for reasons already mentioned. Computer vision is just one of those examples. And the amount of Chinese papers published and cited, conferences, experts, and patents is fast growing. Kai-Fu Li describes how quickly China is growing well in his book, AI Superpowers. He discusses how many Chinese internet companies started out by almost exactly copying the US giants' websites and practices, but they have developed sufficiently that they're now able to innovate and develop on their own. US companies and products essentially bootstrapped their Chinese counterparts. WeChat was inspired by WhatsApp, but WeChat has greatly overtaken its muse. Now we're seeing examples of Chinese companies, applications, and AI that have blown up even in the Western world. You've probably heard of TikTok. That's a great example of how China has been able to innovate and pass the US in some areas. TikTok has been downloaded more than 1.5 billion times on the Apple and Google Play Store and growing wildly. This is crazy. The interesting thing will be if any of these US companies copy their Chinese counterparts more and more as we go forward, and what the implications for our privacy of our data and our differences there. This is going to be fascinating to watch, that's for sure. The future is bright. PwC states that AI could contribute up to $16 trillion to the global economy in 2030. The US and China alone will see about 70% of that AI global impacts economically, or about $10 trillion. They place the growth of the US GDP at $3.7 trillion, with China's growth at $7 trillion. So what does this mean? Well, thanks for asking, Byron. This means that we're facing a rising tide. It will lift both our and China's boats. It's not a zero-sum game here, where the US wins and China loses, or China wins, the US loses. Both countries will surely see large productivity and quality of life benefits from AI in the future. We need to be clear and careful when we're talking about this AI race or competition that it doesn't instill fear and foster negative behaviors. Worse yet, some call this an AI arms race. The danger in just using the term implies that there's a winner and a loser. It also implies some sort of armed conflict, or that our AI needs to be weaponized faster against each other. This is a bad idea for a couple reasons. Number one, there's a lot of good life improvements and things AI can do for the better. We should work towards these goals and not stigmatize and mischaracterize AI as inherently dangerous. And number two, in an AI arms race, each party is incentivized to try and increase their, quote, weapons, and it results in a long-term escalating competitive situation where adversaries need to constantly outdo one another. This could create ethical shortcuts and unnecessarily increase hostile attitudes towards each other. Finally, for the treat, This brings into question what is known as the Thucydides Trap, when a rising power threatens to displace a ruling one. The most likely outcome is war. In Graham Allison's book, Destined for War, 12 out of the 16 cases in which this occurred in the last 500 years ended violently. My favorite quote of Thucydides, it was the rise of Athens and the fear it instilled in Sparta that made war inevitable. Let's not accelerate that fear. Let's make sure these two superpowers do not fall victim to this trap. If you're new to this AI thing, go ahead and watch this video on the basics of AI. I compiled 9 short and basic simple clips from what AI is to deepfakes and attacking AI. AI is fascinating and has great potential to change the world for the better. Let's make sure that the future is bright. Well, you've stuck around this long. That means you obviously love the sound of my voice. Subscribe to see future content if you're not already. And remember to smash that like button. This is Jerry. Keep learning. See ya.